Hello, thank you for coming. I'm Muhammed Kara from Turkey. I will talk about ODF and LibreOffice adoption in Turkey. It's just a status report, actually. I will first give some numbers and talk about current status. Then mention some major players taking part in adoption of ODF and LibreOffice in Turkey. Talk about some example cases, good and bad cases, and try to discuss points of common failure. Then I will also talk about some recent events and fight about LibreOffice and ODF and also GNU/Linux. Current state of public sector is actually going good. There are institutions, public institutions, ministries, municipal hospitals, universities, and also military. Some are in process of migrating to LibreOffice and ODF. Some are already using. There are many institutions, public institutions, wanting to migrate to LibreOffice, and some are already using. In the public sector, currently, as I know, there are more than 100,000 computers confirmed users. Actually, it is, I think, nearing 2,000 recently, but confirmed number is 100,000. There are 26 different public institutions in process of migrating to ODF and LibreOffice. Most of them are also migrating to GNU/Linux completely, or considering the migration. Some are in feasibility state, some are already migrating. And there are also another 50 institutions waiting in line for getting in the process. They have applied to TÜBİTAK ULAKBİM, which is spearheading adoption of LibreOffice and ODF in Turkey. And there are also private sector adopting LibreOffice and ODF. I have been told there is a bank considering for migration to LibreOffice. There are some small businesses already using LibreOffice and ODF. There are some private schools and there are some private institutions and schools shy to share their names, so they are not included here. I said TÜBİTAK ULAKBİM is spearheading the adoption and migration. Let me tell you about, a little about TÜBİTAK ULAKBİM and PARUS project. TÜBİTAK ULAKBİM is Turkish, short for Turkish Academic Network and Information Center. It is a research institute backed by government and semi-independent. It is currently caretaking of PARUS project, which is a Debian-based distro, GNU/Linux distro, and trying to spread open source solutions by means of, by also spreading PARUS Linux. And it also supports development of LibreOffice directly and indirectly. I am working there, and some of my contributions are paid by also TÜBİTAK ULAKBİM. They are also giving contracts to private sector for development of LibreOffice. for ODF, for spreading to ODF and providing support and a knowledge base for institutions. TÜBİTAK Vakfı has prepared a website. It is odf.org.tr. It consists of useful information about ODF, and LIGO is mostly ODF. It describes ODF, gives some guidelines for migrations. There is also a part trying to answer frequently asked questions. There is a forum. People can come and ask their questions, and they can also directly contact TÜBİTAK Vakfı for their needs and questions. There is also Havelsan, which has been lately got involved in the office and part of migrations. It's an affiliated company of Turkish Armed Forces, so again, we can say semi-public. It is a company, but owned by Turkish Armed Forces. They are targeting both private and public sector. TÜBİTAK Vakfı is mainly targeting public sector, but Havelsan is also targeting private sector. They have been conducting some workshops and training programs to train people about GNU Linux, TARDUS and LibreOffice. They are mainly focusing on large migrations, I guess, probably because of financial reasons for the most income. There are also some companies in the private sector which are giving support for migration to LibreOffice and GNU Linux, IT consultancy companies. They are in different cities, mostly providing support. Unfortunately, contribution to upstream is limited from these companies. And because some of them was shy to share their name, I decided to exclude all names. And I would like to give some examples about institutions which are migrating or have migrated to LibreOffice and or part of GNU Linux. There is the example of Pendik municipality in Istanbul. It is a small municipality in Istanbul. They migrated on their own without a substantial support from TÜBİTAK or other institutions. We of course try to support them whenever they need it, but they mostly did it on their own. And they are also leading 8 other municipalities, near municipalities, to migrate to GNU Linux, farms to GNU Linux and LibreOffice. They are even organizing a local conference of open source taking place this October in Istanbul. Another good case, Pendik municipality's migration is almost over. As far as I know, they have just some databases left in non-open source site, and they are trying to also migrate them. Another municipality is Kahramanmaraş. It has just started the migration process. They are working directly with TÜBİTAK Vakfı and TARDUS in the process. They are very enthusiastic and eager to migrate to open source solutions. I have personally visited them, attended a meeting with them. They have highly technical stuff, and they actually agreed to invest in upstream new development after their migration, we will see if they will actually do that. I will follow up and remind them about their promise. There is another good example, which is as part of Ministry of Justice, the courthouses. Ministry of Justice is using in the courthouses, all of courthouses all over Turkey, LibreOffice currently. They at first they migrated to Open Office from MS Office to Open Office. They used that for a while, for a few years. Then a few years ago they switched to LibreOffice. They have about 100,000 computers and 75,000 active users, from judges, lawyers, all people in the system are using ODF and LibreOffice, but they are on Windows right now and evaluating their state to see if they can migrate to also part of Linux. And there is also a bad example, but for obvious reasons I'll call it unnamed institution. They switched, actually they tried to switch, started the switching process, migration process a few years ago, both Parnas GNU Linux and LibreOffice. They have about 2,000 users, but so far only half of them could migrate successfully, and recently the number is in decline. Some of them are returning back to Windows and MS Office. There are many causes for this. Some of them are, I think I know some of them. There are definitely some of them I don't know, and some of them are coming for these migrations. I think I would like to talk about them a little. One of them is OXML compatibility. Because these government institutions are exchanging documents with our institutions, and because already ODF adopted ones are minority currently, they have to use OXML, continue using OXML for shared documents. And incompatibilities, sometimes they take some documents, open in LibreOffice, and they don't see the same result. They experience some issues, and that's one of complaint sources for users. Another one is Turkish language support and Java compatibility, or Zemberek. What is Zemberek? I will explain. Turkish language support is, I think, no longer thanks to Necdet Yücel, last year, they have raised Turkish translation percentage to 100%. There is a Java incompatibility problem. It has been reported that certain features of LibreOffice, like days, fortunately most people are not using days, but they are using spell checker. Zemberek is a spell checker specially written for Turkish language, and it has been used for years LibreOffice, but it hasn't been maintained. At least the extension part used in LibreOffice hasn't been maintained for a long while, and it wasn't compatible with certain Java versions. versions, and it was causing some performance issues. It simply, it was a source of headache for us. And I hope it has been solved. It will be solved with 6.2, because we have added a Turkish dictionary to be used with LibreOffice's hard-style implementation. And there is the post issue. There is a guideline document, official guideline document in Turkey, which should be complied by all government institutions, which specifically names some fonts to be used for shared documents, and they are MS fonts, like Times New Roman, Arial. They are written in the document. You will use these fonts for shared documents. And you know, if you don't have the fonts, it again causes some, at least, visibility issues. We are trying to solve this by changing the document. We have proposed to change those Times New Roman and its friends with LibreFonts, our LibreFonts. It hasn't been solved yet, but we will again follow it. I hope it gets solved soon. And there is also user habits. It's another source of complaints, another source of headache. People usually don't like to change their habits. For example, when they open the print dialog, if they see a button in MS Office, they use to use that button to fit the document into a page, and they don't see it in LibreOffice, they come and ask, where is the button? and that's a valid reason in their perspective.
You have 10 minutes.
And there is also lack of training and planning, which is combined with too much eagerness, I call it. Sometimes some institutions are too eager to migrate to Windows, GNU Linux and LibreOffice, and they would like to organize a press conference and say, "Ooh, we have migrated to GNU Linux. We are heroes." Like that, to be able to say that, they rush the migration. And without proper training and planning, then it causes a lot of trouble afterwards. And about the recent events, I gave numbers of institutions in process of migration and waiting on the line. As you see, there are many institutions waiting on the line. It's because of, partly at least, because of recent events. Recently, for various reasons, the ruling party in Turkey issued an order saying that order to its municipalities and government institutions. They need to switch to Pardus GNU Linux and stop using MS products. And they started rushing into Twitter blogging. We want to switch, we want to switch. That's why there is a long line now. It also caused some press awareness. Now you can see some news about LibreOffice and GNU Linux in news, thanks to these. And there is also a buzz in social media about how GNU Linux and LibreOffice. People started to saying, oh, why are you using MS Office? Just go download LibreOffice. Tweets like these are common nowadays. This caused the hype, but I see this both as an opportunity and a danger. An opportunity because we can reach to more people and more institutions now, and they have a reason to migrate a little easier for us, but also a danger because of if an institution rushes the migration, and because of that rushes the migration and organizes a press conference, we have migrated GNU Linux and LibreOffice, we are using it, it's perfect. Then after a year, if they fail and start going back to MS Office and Windows, it won't be good for our reputation. Any questions?
I'm very happy to hear that your justice department uses LibreOffice on 75,000 computers or even more. According to the Document Foundation Migrations wiki page, it's 75,000 users, and it's only announced that it will be changed or migrated from OpenOffice to LibreOffice. So it would be great to update that.
Yeah.
Also, there are other examples listed here, the Ministry of National Defense, which I think you have not mentioned in your...
That list is not up to date.
Yes, it would be so fantastic to update it, and maybe all those people who are lining up now would also then be asking to update the migrations page.
Yeah, we'll take a look. And I am also especially happy about the Ministry of Justice case, because they did migration silently and they are using it silently. I don't get any complaints from them. They are using it.
And they would complain if they had problems.
Any other questions?
I see some differences between migration. For now, we tell people we don't talk about competitiveness with all accidents because we tell people that it is not necessary to be competitive. We held many small sessions with different institutes or organizations, and gradually tell people that interoperability were not more important. So yeah, I think maybe I'm not sure if you have something like this in more communication, especially with those people. Another failure, I don't know if you have similar problem. Another failure, a key barrier we see in Taiwan is that, okay, now our central government asks everyone to use OEF, but now it's better, but still some people say OEF using Microsoft Office, and that is a disaster. I give you OEF, yes, but it is saved by Microsoft. And if you open it with LibreOffice, it will be not available. Because you didn't mention that, I don't know if you have such question, but for us, it is a key question. So that is also something we mentioned, especially when communicating with people. Tell them that don't use Microsoft, not because it is Microsoft, but because they don't follow the standard.
Currently, we don't have such a problem.
What?
At least, first, all people say some user base. After that, we will try to enforce it. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you.